he would be as well. But brother, you know, he became addicted to heroin. He became addicted to heroin when we were teenagers, you know, when he was a teenager. And he was part of that generation, the kind of early rave generation that a lot of people did. And, you know, heroin kind of proliferated, and it does do in areas of social degradation. And there was a lot of people from our neighbourhood, not necessarily Ireland, but, like, lots of working-class neighbourhoods all over Dublin and Ireland that were getting caught up in that. So my brother did, and became homeless, and we hadn't seen him in a lot of years, you know. We hadn't seen him in about 2-3 years because our relationship had kind of broken down, you know.
And was he in Ireland or abroad?
No, we didn't know where he was.
You didn't know where he was at all?
No, where he was. So I actually just graduated from college, got an audition in London for We Will Rock You, the musical. Didn't get it, as you know. So I went over to London. I was only there for 6 hours because it was kind of fly in, do the audition, come home, you know. It was around Piccadilly or something. And it was September the 11th, 2001. So I was watching Sky News outside a cafe because I seen people congregating outside a cafe looking in at the TV. And then I walked on and I was outside an electronic shop with loads of people. It was like something out of a movie, and I seen the second plane going into the tower. And I was kind of going, this is mad.
Yeah.
And then I walked around a corner and I hadn't seen my brother in 3 years, and then I found him on the street. And
what sort of state was he in, or what was he?
Well, he was living homeless, you know, so he wasn't looking too well.
That's head melt stuff.
Yeah.
You were just watching the second plane go. Turned around the corner after 3 years in the city of London.
Yeah, and I was only there for 6 hours, you know. It's about like 9 million people or something. And kind of like the world was kind of falling apart, essentially, in the West. You know, like this kind of massive terrorist act that was, you know, that was destroying lives, and then kind of two lives kind of reconnect. And
what did you say to him?
It was really normal. It was just kind of, and I know I was talking to someone about this recently, like all those kind of things of families, you know, the arguments that have happened that maybe led to us not kind of are becoming estranged,
yeah, of
kind
course.
Of melt away because he's your brother.
Yeah.
And it's just, and it's really kind of normal. And also, my mother would have told us never to shout in the street, you know. Get in here.
Yeah, yeah. We're going to do this here.
You
yeah.
know.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
But it was just really normal. And we had a chat for a few hours. And I asked him, I said, do you want to come back? And he said, no, I'm not ready yet. But myself, my mother and father went over again looking for him. And we kind of went through the depths of London, you know, the kind of seeing that abject poverty of what
yeah.
people go through. And there's a lot of Irish homeless over there then, as is now, and a lot of addicts. And we got the word out to him to come home. And then he did. And he made the journey back, you know.
How is he?
My brother is doing extremely well. He has a master's degree in psychology. He's a beautiful 7-year-old nephew.
Oh, that's tremendous. That's great.
Yeah, and he has a new baby on the way and a lovely partner. And he's also, he works for the HSC at the moment, and he's involved in shaping drug policy.
So he's completely back on top.
Totally.
Isn't
yeah.
that great news?
And it's like, you know, who better to kind of help shape that? And
yeah.
like what's happened is he's helped, well, thousands of people, because he
yeah.
worked as a counsellor there for 15 years.
He knows
years.
What he's talking about.
Yeah, he knows what he's talking about.
Let me ask you, Emma.